Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and I'm talking PRP versus PRF. Probably one of the most asked questions I get at every training I go to, and a lot of people think PRP is PRF. So what are the differences? PRP I started using about 9 or 10 years ago. I got rid of my PRP about 3 years ago after learning about PRF. PRP is platelet-rich plasma. PRF is platelet-rich fibrin. And as I'm going to talk to you, the fibrin is a key element of this. I learned it first in France and then in Florida, the dentist. I work with a bunch of dentists. And even the other day, I was in Arizona and a dentist came to the course and I said, how many people here do PRP versus PRF? And the dentist was the only person using PRF. And it was amusing to him that we're not using more PRF, because in the dental world, where they're putting in implants, where they're trying to grow bone, PRF is a staple. So PRP, or platelet-rich plasma, as you can see from this slide, has a lot of plasma at the top, whereas platelet-rich fibrin has less volume. And a lot of people are hung up on this. Imagine though, having plasma that doesn't do very much versus low volume of our platelet-rich fibrin, which is rich in, and most importantly, white cells and a fibrin matrix. So white cells are known to have an important role in growth factors. And you can see from this slide here, which shows a higher degree of white blood cells in PRF, or platelet-rich fibrin, over PRP. So that's the first most important and studied factor, is that we want blood cells. The next is the fibrin. And in this slide, you can see the fibrin matrix at the top are the two PRP. There's PRP and then PRP with the white cells. And then below, look at the thickness of the fibrin matrix when you have platelet-rich fibrin with the white blood cells. Now the spin speed, a lot of people ask, and PRF is a slow spin speed. And as a side note, a lot of times the spinners that people have for PRP will not work because they're too fast. And also, I really believe the angle, and the dentists agree with this as well, plays an important role in producing good PRF. So a lot of times you need the specific spinners, and the new ones are very small and easy, and you can put one in each room. They're very quiet, but it's a slow speed. That's important because it doesn't disrupt the cells. And so when you don't disrupt the cells, you have more pure cells, non-disrupted cells, but the fibrin matrix, because there's no heparin or sodium citrate in the tube, and if you have PRFM, I was in a practice yesterday, there actually was sodium citrate in the tube, and then you had to activate it with calcium. None of that exists in pure PRF. But when you put it in the body, it forms a fiber matrix, and you get slow release of growth factors over about a week. And you can see from this slide, the growth factors present in platelet-rich fibrin, and they slowly release over the week. And that means you're bathing that area in rich factors that are gonna help reduce the appearance of fine lines. I believe that some of the fat, we're maybe plumping it up. We're at almost 2,500 under eyes here in my practice, and I can tell you there's a very high patient satisfaction. Let's talk about the plug that separates PRP. With PRP, it's a fast spin speed and a plug that separates the buffy coat from the PRF, where you can just take whatever you want from the top because there's no plastic plug. The plastic plug has been implicated in studies to actually have micro doses of plastic that we pull up and then inject. So more pure, more natural, no plastic, slow spin speed, white blood cells, more growth factors, and the all-important fibrin matrix. Now there is about 17 minutes of user time, but it's a very quick injection, so it doesn't usually affect most clinics. And if you microneedle it, like the dentist, you can use the clot. They use the clotted portion, which is great as well. So there's many ways to use PRF. That's the main difference, and several differences. More importantly to me, it seems much more effective, to the point where I don't use my PRP any further. If you have further questions or comments, we'd love to hear it below on this YouTube channel. Also, pop over to our Instagram, where there's continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.